It is February 19th. This is WGTV Today, Wayne Goldsboro Television. I'm Wayne Alley.
And I'm Kim Best. Good morning, and thank you for joining us.
We appreciate you being with us this morning. We have, on the 19th of February, a full lineup. What's going on today there, Kim?
We will hear from Cricket, who is here from the Wayne County. No, it's not.
The Goldsboro Family Y.
There you go.
She's in Wayne County.
Yes, it is. Cricket's here to tell us all about the exciting programs that the Family Y offers our community.
That's exactly right.
Then we'll hear from Catherine Lachaud from United Wayne, and we'll hear from Wayne County Reads.
Oh boy, Wayne County Reads. And the book, of course, is Bless Me Ultima by Rodolfo Anaya. And we'll be talking about that. And I'm looking forward to Cricket Davis being here.
She does a great job.
She does a great job for the Goldsboro Family Y.
Mm-hmm. She's telling us about many of the programs that they'll offer throughout the year and several things that have just taken place that we can look forward to next year.
You know, when that Family Y was being planned and when it was being built many years ago, there were those who said, well, we don't need this, we don't need that. But let me tell you something. We have one of the finest YMCAs in the southeastern part of the country. I mean, people come from all over the country here for swim meets, all sorts of competition. And the exercise rooms are great, and just the Family Y itself is the Family Y. And it's a great, if you don't belong to the Y, you should. It's just a great place to go.
It certainly is. You'll hear more about it coming up.
That's right.
Well, there's something going on at Wayne Community College. It's called Women in Business.
What's going on with that?
In honor of Women's History Month, a series of seminars entitled Women in Business will be held beginning on March 6th, so mark your calendars. They'll serve a light breakfast. Please pre-register online at ncsbc.net. That's ncsbc.net. Or you can call 739-6940 if you're interested in taking these classes. It's free, no cost to you. They'll be at 9 o'clock in the morning. It'll be a one-hour class from 9 to 10, Wednesday, March the 6th.
There you go. Okay, mark on your calendars also. You know, by the time we get finished, it's going to be
marked
all over
full.
Your calendar.
If anybody ever tells you there's nothing going on in Goldsboro and Wayne County, you say, I know differently.
Yeah,
I hear it every morning on WGTV.
I just don't know. I don't have anything to do.
Well, they're not listening then,
Wayne?
Because there's plenty to do in our community.
That's right. For instance, coming up on April, the first week of April, the Junior Livestock Show and Sale gets underway, and that is a big deal. We are an agricultural community.
Yes, we are.
And even people who are not interested in agriculture will find this a lot of fun, interesting, fascinating. The first week of April, the Junior Livestock Show and Sale gets underway at the Wayne Regional Agricultural Fairgrounds. And between now and then, in fact, this week, the workshops are underway. Today's the 19th. That means it started yesterday. So the workshops are underway. And between now and the rest of this month on into March, there'll be 9 workshops, and if you're participating in these in the show and sale, you need to attend at least 2 of these workshops. It's better if you go to all of them, but you have to attend at least 2 if you're participating. And this is a great event, the Junior Livestock Show and Sale program coming up. Talk to Eileen Coit with the Cooperative Extension Service.
That's right.
Eileen's number is 731-1520.
You think?
Or 731-1525.
There
Either
you
number
go.
Will work. Okay.
Well, Wayne, there's a magical evening of circus that'll be taking place at Mount Olive College.
Whoa.
They're having a winter glitz. It's Saturday, February the 23rd, 6 p.m. to 10 p.m. You will have a dinner, a magical evening with auctions and all kinds of things happening. It's a winter glitz 2013. Let's see. Guests will enjoy the thrills of the big top with circus entertainment, elegant dining, and special vocal performances by American Idol contestant Blair Mazingo, of course your former Miss Goldsboro.
Yes.
A live and silent auction will be held to raise money for student scholarships at Mount Olive College. Come be a child at heart this special evening. Tickets are $75 per person or $125 per couple. You can contact Ann Hamm at 919-658-7822 for more information or to purchase tickets. Once again, that's Saturday, February the 23rd, Mount Olive College in the Lois K. Murphy Regional Center.
Okay.
Yes.
Scientific predictions.
Our trivia question of the day.
Our trivia question of the day. Scientific predictions.
Okay.
Everyone knows the name Sir Isaac Newton.
Yes.
Of course, scientist, philosopher, and all this stuff from years ago. He, at one time, predicted the apocalypse
yes.
would come. The apocalypse, the end, would come. In fact, he predicted it would happen in this century.
Okay.
He did. He said, in this century, in the 21st century, the apocalypse will happen. We'll narrow it down. Within five, what year did Sir Isaac Newton predict the apocalypse would happen in this century?
Hmm.
In what year? Within five, either way.
Ponder.
That's wrong. Oh, wait a minute. No, we're never...
Think
yeah,
on that
ponder
one.
Ponder that one. Think about it.
That's
I
right.
Mean, you're only picking a number here, and there's
That's
only
right.
100 of them from which to choose.
How can we go wrong?
I'm telling you. and I'm giving you within five. All right?
All right. I'm going to let you have
five.
That one. That's something you might
okay.
be interested in.
Oh, here we go. Yes. Yes.
Well, tell us
what
about
is this?
It.
Oh, each year, the Center for Environmental Farming Systems hosts an annual lecture series. It brings a distinguished national or international leader in food systems work to our community. Now, this year, we're excited to host Maya Wiley.
Mm-hmm.
Maya Wiley is an amazing, nationally recognized advocate and activist for good, healthy food. Oh,
yeah.
Boy. Good health, not lousy food, good food.
Healthy food.
And healthy. Yeah, but I love healthy food. Anyway. She'll be speaking at Goldsboro High Wayne School of Engineering Auditorium February 27th, which is on a Wednesday at 10:30. In fact, that's a week from tomorrow.
Is it? Okay.
A week from tomorrow. The event open to the community. Anybody and everybody can go to this thing. If you like information about it, you need to talk to Shorelette Ammons. And Shorelette's at 288-0192. 288-0192. This is the Goldsboro High School Auditorium on Beach Street. And we'll be on February 27th at 10:30 in the morning. We're talking about good, healthy food here, and it's free to go and attend. And free to go and attend.
Well, Wayne, I think it's time to go, and let's hear from United Way, Catherine Lachaud, and Wayne County Reads.
Oh, boy.
Joining me this morning is Catherine Lachaud with the United Way. She's here to talk about a program. It's called My Free Taxes. Good
yeah.
morning.
Good morning.
Welcome to the show.
Thank you.
So
glad to
you
be here.
All have a program that is My Free Taxes that is already working here in our community.
Yes. My Free Taxes is a program where if you as an individual or a family have a combined income of $57,000 or less, you can file your federal and state taxes for free. So you're able to keep a little bit more of your hard-earned money by using myfreetaxes.com/UnitedWayne is the entire link. And you just go on there and it's very easy, user-friendly. You create your own login and just input all of your information.
So what is the advantage to using this particular tax resource versus any other in our community?
Well, just that you can keep more of your earned income tax credit by using this, and also the United Way just gets some of the demographic information, which is going to help us be able to better serve the community in general, because we'll be able to kind of see demographics of our
right.
community.
Right.
So we'll use that going forward.
Well, have you already found that people are already taking advantage of this program?
Yes. We have not been promoting it that heavily yet because it just started going live
mm-hmm.
the end of January, beginning of February.
So it's brand new.
Yes, it's brand new, and we've already had people that are creating accounts. They, the My Free Taxes people, they send us some information. You know, this
right.
is how many people who are going to the site, and these are how many people who have registered. So we're just hoping that this becomes a tool that the community will use.
So is this going to be an ongoing tool for
yes.
us?
Yes, and of course it will be available through the tax season,
right.
and then they'll, I'm sure, make enhancements for the next year, but we're planning to offer this every year.
That sounds great. So now if somebody wanted to come in and talk with you all in person, would you all have someone there that could sort of guide you through?
Well, United Way does not have a tax person that's available to kind of counsel you
that's
if what you
what I was
should
wondering.
Do.
Mm-hmm.
But My Free Taxes online, when you go to the website, they have numbers that you can call, and it is through H&R Block, so it is the tax certified person who will not lead you astray, and they have the help that you might need. if you encounter any questions.
Can you give us the website for United Way?
Yes, it's United Wayne, like the county, WAYNE.org.
Perfect, because so many times people aren't sure of that particular website.
Yes.
So I want to make sure we say that a couple times.
Yes, and when you go to our website, there is a My Free Taxes link at the bottom, and that will bring you right to the page. So if you can't remember myfreetaxes.com/UnitedWayne, you can just remember United Wayne.
Exactly. So you click right on the link, and it'll take you to the right page.
Yep.
And you will have to set up a login, create, you know, user information.
Yes, and of course it is on the internet, and I know that some people are still hesitant about putting all of that information online, and that's okay, but for those who are comfortable doing that, we think that this is a great tool for them to use.
Wonderful. Well, Catherine, is there anything else going on at United Way?
Right now, that's pretty much what we have going on, and Bank On, I know Lee was talking to you about that, so those are things that we have going on the horizon.
That sounds great. Thank you so much for being with us today.
Thank you.
We appreciate it. If you're interested in finding out more about My Free Taxes, you can contact various people at United Way, and they'll be glad to walk you through the process. Thank you for being with us, and this is what's happening at United Way.
Hello, my name is Rodolfo Anaya, and I'm here to discuss my novel, Bless Me Ultima. I fell in love with books when my mother taught me my catechism at home. And then later on, I remember I would read The Hardy Boys, and I'd read a lot of Westerns about cowboys and Nancy Drew. I grew up in the oral tradition of family and friends telling stories in a Spanish-speaking family. You see, at home, we didn't have books. And I didn't know the magic of words until I went to school and picked up a book. And then in town, there was a library on top of the old fire station. It was a small room, and one of the teachers in the school volunteered on Saturdays to open the library. You know, that was the opening of my world into books, because in this little dusty room with Miss Pansy, checking out books, I could finally take books home. And oh man, that was excitement, because I had books. I finally had books. And I think books are salvation, you know. Books are the mirror in which we see ourselves. I find myself every time I write something, because writing is an exploration. And the exploration is not only for me, it's for the reader. That's why the library is so important. The writers of the world are there, and the readers can share in that journey. I loved my university experience. What happened is, when I was studying literature at the university, I fell in love with literature. But when I start to write, somehow those models don't fit me. I have to find my own way of writing, and in order to find that, I need to ask guidance from my ancestors. It comes from our culture. It's a belief that they can help me. And so they're the ones that are going to guide me. And in principle, in Bless Me Ultima, it's the healer who comes to guide me. A curandera is a healer. These are women, can be a man, who practice helping people when they're sick. Bless Me Ultima takes place in a small town in eastern New Mexico, and it's really the setting of my hometown, Santa Rosa, New Mexico. Many of the characters that appear are my childhood friends. I used to write late at night. I felt something behind me, and I turned, and there is this old woman dressed in black, and she asked me what I'm doing. I said, well, I'm trying to write about my childhood, you know, about growing up in that small town. And she said, well, you'll never get it right until you put me in it. And I said, well, who are you? And she said, Ultima. Ultima is the curandera who comes to stay with Antonio's family at the beginning of the novel. With Ultima, he begins to experience something different. He begins to see a totality of life, and he begins to see beauty where there was no beauty. He begins to ask questions about life and death and about good and evil. You get a sense that this woman is so powerful, she can not only be at his birth, but now that he's almost seven, she can be at his rebirth. There isn't only one way to look at the world. Ultima says there are other ways. And so I started to write, and I would write poetry. I even tried writing sonnets. During that time, I would write poetry for girls that I met, because this was a great way to meet girls. But one never knows, you know, I'm going to be a writer. I'm going to be famous. This book will be known 30 years after I write it. That doesn't happen. You just do it because somehow that's what you're meant to do. I started writing Bless Me Ultima when I was a student at the university. I was learning to write. It was a first novel. I had to learn to use my culture, my traditions, my history, and put them in a novel, and that hadn't been done. Night after night after night, revision after revision of a novel. It's kind of insanity, you know? Finally, I got it to a point where I thought it was ready, and I started sending it around to East Coast publishers, and it was rejected many, many times. One night, I was reading a magazine by a press in Berkeley, Quinto Sol, and for the first time, they were publishing Chicano literature. And I remember turning to my wife and saying, you know, I can write as good as those guys. And so I packaged the novel off and sent it to them. And they wrote back and said, yeah, we want to publish it. Not only that, we want to give it a literary prize. And that was the beginning of my publishing career. I believe that every writer needs a guide, especially if you're going to deal with questions that have to do with human nature, the good and evil in our lives. But the key to writing for me has always been to go as deep as I can into the story, because that's where we discover ourselves. That's where we make a connection to every human being that has ever existed. That's what ties us together. That's what makes us human. And that's where the guide comes in, the mentor. And so Ultima becomes a mentor for Antonio in the story and becomes a mentor for me, the writer. Somehow, Bless Me Ultima captures the soul of a people, of a community. And it's not very often we can do it as writers, and that's to be shared with the world. I am Antonio in the novel. Obviously, I have this connection to him because I'm seeing the world from his point of view, first person. But I think for the reader, the end is, you know, let the reader decide, what does Antonio become? Does he become a priest? And I say, no, maybe he becomes a writer.
If you were a book, what book would you be?
If I were a book, I would be a notebook that has not been written in, so I could write my own story. That's one version. You should, so you want me to tell you the other one?
That's a wrap.
That's a good, that's a very good review.
On WGTV today?
Yes, we are.
Aren't we?
Well, Wayne, I want to tell you about something that's coming up at the Paramount Theater.
What's going on?
On March 28th, Music Man.
February 28th.
February 28th. Got to get that right. February 28th. The Music Man will be taking place by Stage Struck Children's Theater.
Yeah.
Oh, my goodness. They have somewhere between 75 and 100 children participating in
wow.
that particular production.
Oh, that's great.
It is a musical. It's their premiere production that they hold every spring. And you're talking about talent. You need to go and see it because there'll be a lot of local talent. Our youth performing on the stage together. They've practiced for months to prepare for this. So if you haven't gotten your tickets, call StageStruck or go to StageStruck.org and get your tickets now to The Music Man, February 28th.
It's one of my favorite. I love
Is
The
it?
Music Man, yeah.
Well, they put on a very good professional show, and I can guarantee you the sets will be out of this world. Mm. They always are. I mean, we have people in this community that volunteer, like Bill Royal, and the list goes on and on and on, of these people who build these sets from scratch.
I know Bill Royal.
Paint them. Oh, yeah. Paint them, decorate them, and they are fabulous.
Yeah.
They're not what you expect from a children's theater, I can guarantee you that.
So, and to take that just a step further, these are professional people who build these sets.
Oh, yes.
And
they're volunteering their time.
Yeah, yeah.
For every show, they start from scratch, and they have a vision, this set crew, of what they would like the background to look like when these children are up there acting and singing and showing you their talents on stage. Oh, yeah. And Bill Royal and his crew always create something brand new and
they
fabulous.
They are great.
They are.
Well, today, February 19th, this day in 1934, Bob and Dolores got married. Oh.
Bob and Dolores who?
Bob Hope and Dolores.
There you go.
Reed was her last name, her maiden name. Bob Hope and Dolores Reed married this day in Erie, PA. The marriage lasted 69 years.
Just 69 years,
Wayne? Only 69 years until he died at the age of 100 about 10 years ago. I can't believe he's been dead 10 years.
I can't either. I really cannot. Mm-hmm.
They adopted four children. They couldn't have children of their own. They adopted four. Kelly and Zachary, Linda and Tony were Bob Hope's and Dolores Hope's children. And in fact, in his routines, you often heard Bob Hope talk about his wife Dolores.
Yes. He certainly did.
1964 was the year when 1,000 pounds arrived from England in New York City. It was 1,000 pounds of Beatle wigs.
Beatle wigs?
Remember the Beatles?
Yes.
Well, back in 1964, when they first became known, and the world went wild over the Beatles, Beatlemania they called it.
Yes.
Everybody had to wear their hair like the Beatles. I mean, that was just a popular thing to do. They didn't want to grow their hair out.
They wanted instant gratification.
They didn't want exactly. They didn't necessarily want to wear the mop tops. So Beatle wigs became very popular, and over 1,000 pounds of Beatle wigs arrived in England this day, 1964, where they sold out immediately.
Oh my goodness! Everybody wanted to be a Beatle.
That's right.
At least for a day.
Betty. To fat, 1977. She lived in Cuyahoga, Ohio. She was a person who crocheted a lot.
Okay.
In fact, she crocheted a wool chain 11 miles long.
That is loving to crochet just a bit.
Just a bit. She,
just a bit.
Of course, she didn't have a life. She didn't have anything
else
to do.
That was
she
her
just
life.
Crocheted. That was her life. 1998 it was. The Duke and Duchess of Windsor's 60-year-old wedding cake.
Oh, wow.
A piece of it sold for $29,900 at an auction in New York City.
I'm hoping it had been frozen for years.
It had been frozen, but anyway. And the story there is a fascinating story, but that's beside the point. We won't get into that because it's just too long. Anyway, a burglar left hanging upside down from a window in 02, 11 years ago today. He was left hanging upside down, had to call the police to help him get out of that situation. He called him on his cell phone. Hello, police, I need your help. He was a 42-year-old, was trying to break into a nursery in Linz, Austria, when his foot got caught as he went through a sloping window. He could not break free. He called the cops. The officers had to take out the window frame, in fact, to free the guy. So anyway, he's still in jail. Anyway, today having birthdays.
Yes, whose birthday is it?
Smokey Robinson.
Woo! He can play some good music.
Love that guy. Yeah, you know he's a doctor.
I did not know that. Doctor of what?
Philosophy.
Okay.
His mama always said, always have something to fall back on.
I'd say
just
he did.
In case it doesn't work out. You know, kind of like Tammy Wynette, always had her hairdresser license.
Yep.
So he went and continued college and graduated. Now he's a great role model.
Yes.
Continued and graduated college, went on and got his doctorate.
Wow.
He's 72 years today. Talk about a talent. Smokey Robinson.
No doubt. Who else's birthday is it?
And by the way, his name is William Charles.
Hmm.
Smokey. Lou Christie, having a birthday. Lightning Strikes and a whole bunch of other songs. He's 69 years today. The singer Seal.
Yes.
A lot of people know Seal. He's mm-hmm. still very popular. He's 49 today. And Bonnie Prince Andrew of Great Britain. Prince Andrew, having a birthday. He is 52.
Did you call him Bonnie?
Bonnie Prince. That's a term. That's a
term.
Oh. Just a loving term.
A loving term. I didn't know what that meant.
Bonnie Prince Andrew.
Like handsome or fair?
Yeah. It means handsome or fair or something like that. Anyway.
Okay. Yeah. Prince Andrew's how old?
52 today.
52. Happy 52. Birthday,
happy,
Prince
happy
Andrew.
There, Andy. Bonnie Andy. Bonnie.
And to all the rest of you who have birthdays out there today.
Now, he's a neat guy, though. He's a good guy. All right.
Good. Let's see.
What else do we have?
A literary festival and poem slam that'll be taking place.
A poem slam?
That's what it says.
All right.
Hey. Literary festival and a poem slam.
Poem slam.
Tuesday, March the 12th, 7 p.m. at Mount Olive College in Southern Bank Auditorium. Richard Chess will be the featured author at Mount Olive College's literary festival. Let's see, the Poetry Slam will have an entry fee for $1. That's $1. My goodness, so you can enter your poetry for $1. There'll be a $100 cash prize for the winner. How about that? For more information, if you have questions about this, you can call Mr. Moore at 919-658-7846. That's at Mount Olive College, Leonard Moore, 658-2548. 02 or 7846, either one. You got some poetry for us?
Roses are red.
Uh-oh.
Violets are blue.
Yes.
E-I-E-I-O.
May not win. You got a backup plan?
I'll work on it.
Work on that, Wayne.
Yeah, I'll become a doctor.
But that's March the 12th. If you're interested in entering your poetry for a cash prize of $100, give them a call.
Oh. I'll be with you in a moment.
No problem.
Blood drive. Got a blood drive coming up on today's the 19th. Tomorrow at Wayne Community College starts at 9 in the a.m. 9 o'clock tomorrow morning at Wayne Community College. And if you can't give tomorrow, of course, you know you can give every 56 days. Mm-hmm. There's another blood drive coming up on the 24th, beginning at 8:30 at the Bridge Princeton.
Mm-hmm.
And that's on Whitley Church Road, of course. The Bridge in Princeton is the site of a blood drive. On the 24th. Then there's a blood drive on the 28th. Southern Bank and Trust Company, Community Blood Drive in Mount Olive on Brazil Avenue. That's the main branch there. In Mount Olive, Southern Bank and Trust on February 28th. There was one planned for the 31st, but they canceled that one.
Okay. Well, if you're interested in terrariums, there's a terrarium building workshop, don't laugh, with Jesse Strickland. Thursday, February the 28th at 7 p.m., and that'll be taking place in the Will Auditorium at Wayne County Public Library. Bring your own container, and we'll supply the rest of the things that you'll need.
Terrariums.
You know what I said?
Yeah.
Okay, terrarium building workshop.
No, I like terrariums.
Okay, good. Yeah, Go to the workshop. Build yourself a terrarium.
I could.
You have to take your own. Starts at 7 p.m., Thursday, February 28th. Build your terrarium, Wayne, and then bring it back and show us what you created.
I don't think so. I am not that talented.
Neither am I.
I'm not that. Of course, you don't have to have talent to enjoy it. If you don't have any talent, that's okay. Go anyway.
Take your own container.
Take
February
your own container.
28th, 7 p.m., Will Auditorium, Wayne County Public Library.
Be there.
Or be square. That's right.
All right.
But Wayne, who are we supposed to be going off to now? I believe we're going to see Cricket Davis.
Cricket Davis with the Goldsboro Family Y is up next on WGTV Today.
Today is Cricket Davis. She's the Associate Executive Director with Goldsboro Family YMCA. Good morning, Cricket.
Good morning, Kim. Thanks so much for having us today.
Absolutely. We're so glad to have you guys on board now. You're coming once a month to share all the activities that are happening at the Y. And my goodness, you have a lot.
Yeah, we're really, really busy. And something I failed to mention when you and I were talking a little bit earlier is I got to thinking the other day, I've been at the Y for 25 years, and in a year and a half, we'll be celebrating our 30th year anniversary.
Oh, that's awesome.
Yeah, so it's really good. I mean, we have such a fantastic facility for our area, and
You have a large group of members that are mm-hmm. so dedicated. They come mm-hmm. on such a regular basis and support everything the Y does.
Mm-hmm. We've got over 10,000 members. So that
10,000.
Touches a ton of people in Wayne County.
It certainly does. Tell me what the YMCA is, first of all.
Okay, the YMCA, of course, stands for the Young Men's Christian Association. And basically what our mission statement is to put Christian principles into practice through programs that create healthy body, mind, and spirit for all. And we are an all-inclusive facility. One of the best compliments that we received within the last year is we had somebody from YUSA come, and they were talking about after we went in the Y first, and then we kind of drove around the community, and he said, "You have the largest representation of a total community in any YMCA I've ever seen." And that is a huge compliment to us.
Oh, yes, it is.
You know, because years and years and years ago, when I first started working at the Y, we had like 900 members, and it was not that way.
Mm-hmm.
But I mean, you know, there's everybody, all ages, all, you know, just from everywhere is in the Y. And I mean, you can drive past and the parking lot's full.
It's always
day
full.
Long.
It is.
And that's a good problem.
Yes, it is. Yes, it is. Tell me some of the programs that the community may not be aware of that you all offer.
Okay. I'm going to tell you about some that just recently were in the past, just because one of them is like my greatest passion. We have something called the Wise Men Program. And we started it about 12 years ago. And basically, I was looking for a way for us to help families in Wayne County that were not receiving assistance from somewhere else. And, you know, we always do a joining fee special. I thought, well, instead of waiving the complete joining fee, we'll have people bring in a gift card. We'll collect the gift cards. And then I found agencies to work with. Well, since then, it's grown a lot. I mean, we've been doing, the first year, I think we did like $10,000. And then last year, it was like $16,500. And then this past December, we did over $20,000 in assistance.
Oh my goodness, that is fantastic.
It's huge. And we did not have as many folks join this year because I think people were real afraid of the fiscal cliff,
you know.
But people in the community stepped up because a lot of people just don't even know what goes on at the Y.
Yes.
And so as I was sharing with people, I'm like, you know, this is something that goes directly to the people. And what we do is we work with the Boys and Girls Club and Wayne Uplift Domestic Violence Program. We work with the base. We work with the school system, some of the churches. And then we started, because everybody goes, "Is that just for kids?" I'm like, no. I mean, it's meant to touch everyone. And so we started working with 3HC. And so we'll get a couple of names. Well, we won't get names from them, but we'll get stuff that they need. And then the caseworker can go take it to them. I mean,
these are items that families need here in our community.
And they can buy, I mean, on the night of the celebration, we have all these great, I have volunteers have been coming every year. And we all meet in one place at the Y, and we take the kids to one area where we entertain the kids and, you know, just do all kinds of fun, great things with them. And then we gather with the volunteers and the parent or the guardian, and they get to go shopping. And of course, I have a lot of people like, "Oh, I love to shop. I'll be glad to take them." Because a lot of times people just don't know how to, you know, make the most of what they've got.
Right, exactly.
And so they go shopping. Usually it's at like Walmart or Target.
Mm-hmm.
Because there's such a variety of things there. Some families purchase bare necessities because that's what
really?
They need. Yeah. You know, and you know, I have volunteers every year go, "I bought them a Christmas tree. Is that okay?" You know, and I'm like, sure. You know, because they don't have a Christmas tree. And, you know, and then they kind of keep in contact with each other. So it's been a tremendous thing. And it's my favorite thing. I mean, it's not one of the things we raise the most money for, but it's just an opportunity for us to touch the community.
Right. You know what it's doing for the people that are the most needy in our community.
Mm-hmm.
Now, this is something you all do every year now. It's an mm-hmm. annual event.
Mm-hmm. It is. And this past year was our 12th year. And so, you know, I've just been amazed at how it's grown and how people have, because they're like, "I've never even heard of this."
Well, number one, we have a very giving community.
Mm-hmm.
And we also have an extremely collaborative community. Mm-hmm. I heard you mention earlier that with so many of your different programs, you collaborate with various agencies here in our community. And I think Wayne County and the city of Goldsboro are known for that all
mm-hmm.
over the state.
Mm-hmm.
When I've gone to many meetings, I hear other communities say, "Well, our community is not quite as collaborative." I hear you say you work with so many different groups. Well, that's what we do.
Mm-hmm.
We don't know any different. You know, just so many agencies continue to do that. And it sounds like you all do the
same
thing.
That's what makes it stronger. We had a big community initiative that we started on in 2009, we wrote a grant for something called Pioneering Healthier Communities. And it's a grant through the YMCA of USA and the CDC. And so we had 30 different organizations, including the city of Goldsboro, the county, the health department, the hospital, you know, the Boys and Girls Club, a huge mm-hmm. group of folks. And so we wrote this grant and we received it. We were so excited about it because a lot of times you work in these groups and then nothing comes to fruition. Well, last summer we planted a community garden at Fairview Homes.
Oh, yes, I heard about that.
And then we, the next month, put a track in down there. And it was just
this
amazing.
Is a walking track?
Mm-hmm. Uh-huh. Yep, and it's eight feet wide so people can be out there with their strollers.
Right.
We've done some activities and things, and we're still not through because we're going to program it through and just do, we're trying to find out now what the community wants because
right.
we don't need to go in there and tell them what
right,
we want
right.
for them
that's
to
always
have.
The best scenario is to find out what the community wants, what they'll use,
mm-hmm.
and then, but it's all promoting healthy lives, mm-hmm. living a healthy life.
And it's just been wonderful. I mean, Mayor King went with us when we went to D.C. for our first like big meeting, and I think something that struck out in his mind was that our children today, the life expectancy is like mid-60s.
Because we don't live as healthy
right.
a life as generations before
yeah,
us?
Yeah, I mean, and it was one of those things that's just like stuck with him because he's
right.
like, I'm telling you, you know him, he's like, I'm telling you, y'all got to realize that we need to do something. So
right.
when we were able to do that, and that to us was for us to be able to give a gift like that to the city by
mm-hmm.
having that track and
yes.
all that stuff, it's
yes.
just been tremendous for everybody. So that's an ongoing thing. The two events I was telling you that we just had this past weekend, we had a half marathon and a 5K on Saturday morning.
Y'all do that quite a bit, don't you?
Yeah, and it was 17 degrees.
Wow, that's commitment. That is commitment.
But we had over 300 people that came out from all over the place. The Village of Walnut Creek is always very accommodating. They let us use that, and it was just a great event, and I was so thankful that my volunteers showed up and stayed to help. And all the extra funding from that goes to our financial assistance program, which I'll touch on in just a second. And the same night, we had our father-daughter dance. And that was our 11th annual father-daughter dance. And we, you know, that is to me one of the sweetest things.
Oh, yes.
I always like to be at the front door when I can to see them come in because the girls will come in and they'll have gone, got a manicure, and
oh,
they've got
so
their hair
up.
Done.
Yeah,
and
they're
it's
so
just,
proud to be with their dads. Mm-hmm. It's a special night.
It's a great night. And it's through our mentoring program, which
mm-hmm.
is called WARM. It's Wayne Area Role Models. So, you know, if people are looking for an opportunity to volunteer,
right.
to be a mentor, you know, it's only a two-hour-a-week commitment. And it's just a really great thing. We based it on the Big Brother Big Sister program,
yes.
and just kind of put a Y twist on it. So that's just a really good program. So that pretty much like held us out for the month of February. The 1st of March we're going to do our campaign for financial assistance, and it's called We Build People because that's basically, you know, what the Y does. And last year we gave over $400,000 away in financial assistance, and I think people
in
were,
1 year.
Mm-hmm.
Wow, that is amazing.
It's a lot.
I don't think the people in our community, or I know I didn't,
mm-mm.
realize how much the Y does
mm-hmm.
overall for our entire community,
mm-hmm.
not just the members of the Y.
Right, right. And I mean, this is like, we do things for group homes. We do stuff for the Boys and Girls Clubs, for the Boy Scouts. We do a lot of in-kind things. But we don't turn anybody away due to inability to pay ever. I mean, and it may be, people go, well, I make too much money, but somebody comes in and says, you know, I just got diagnosed with cancer, I'm the breadwinner in the family, you know, and it's like, we're going to work out something for you. Everybody pays a little something, but we're going to work out something for you because it's important for you to be here.
Right.
And, you know, some of the stories, you know, through the years have just been amazing. These kids that otherwise would have not grown up in a positive environment have just done so well, and they'll come back and see us, and it's
right.
a great thing. But, you know, for us to be able to do that, like, you know, Raleigh and a bunch of other communities do that for their YMCA, and they will only give out as much financial assistance as they receive monies for. And so thankfully we've been able to do that by, you know, shuffling things,
because mm-hmm.
Some things, you know, are not a huge overhead for us, but
right.
like preschool and after school, I mean, we teachers and snacks and
that you have to
and
do
all that
you
sort
have to
of
provide.
Stuff. But I mean, you know, I can never, I hope the day never comes when somebody comes to me and says, I need your help, and I
and
can't,
you can't
help
do
them.
It.
So
well, you all have been
yeah.
fantastic so far in the community, being able to allow any and everyone that comes to the Y to be able to participate,
mm-hmm.
and such a good positive influence on lives that may not have had that without the Y.
Mm-hmm. It's a great. I mean, it's just, and it's such a good cross section of folks, and nobody knows who's on financial assistance, and you know, you would never know it at all. And so I encourage people. I know it's hard sometimes, but you know, with the economy being like it is, you need that outlet.
Right, right.
And so it's just real important that people know that we do that. And so we'll be doing that from March 1st to March 31st. And if people would like to make a donation, we don't ask for a whole lot, but every little bit helps us. And,
right.
you know, they can go to our website, which is www.goldsboroymca.org.
Okay.
And there's information about all of our programs on there because we do so much. We do
so
many things. And you know, I could talk for 5,000 years. But, you know, it's just those kind of things that are important to us.
Right.
And to make sure that we're providing for our community. Because, you know, one of the big things when they made the logo change, too, is like we're strengthening the foundations of community. And that's exactly what it is.
That's exactly what the Y does.
You know, and we're you know, we'll go pick up the Boys and Girls Club and bring them to the Y to go swimming. Or we'll go out and I do exercise ministry at my church in Eureka. You know, and it's no charge to the people that come there or whatever. So we're always kind of doing...
Reaching out
to everybody. And that's what we're all about.
Wow. I'm overwhelmed with all the different entities that go into what makes up the Family Y and the Goldsboro Family Y right here in Goldsboro. Gracious. Well, Cricket, thank you so much. Thank you guys for joining and coming on a monthly basis, because I think that'll be a great outlet for our community to always be abreast of what's happening, what's coming up, the opportunities for different people. Everybody, actually. Everybody in the community has the opportunity. From little children all the way up to the oldest senior citizen.
And we've got a lot of those, too.
Yes, you do.
It's awesome.
Yes, you do.
It's a great group.
Well, thank you so much. And if you're interested in participating at the Goldsboro Family Y, Cricket gave you the website. Check it out and see what opportunities are waiting for you.
And we're back on WGTV Today. Thank you for being with us on this 19th. Gee whiz. Today is Tuesday already.
Yes, it is. Yes, it is.
So what does that mean? It means it's not Monday, right?
That's right.
Woo! Thank goodness for that.
Well, Wayne, we want you to save the date and join us at a transportation forum here in our community.
A transportation forum.
That's right. We're going to have a keynote speaker who is the North Carolina Department of Transportation Secretary Tony Tata.
Right.
He'll be there Thursday, February the 28th at Goldsboro Country Club. If you're interested in coming to hear about what kind of transportation they're talking about using in the future of Wayne County and Goldsboro, you need to come to this. Call Wayne County Chamber of Commerce at 734-2241 if you'd like to register to be a part of this transportation forum on Thursday, February the 28th at Goldsboro Country Club.
You know, you stop and think about where we are in the state.
That's right.
We're right in the middle of eastern North Carolina. I mean, and we are a perfect location to be a hub for, if you think about it, Greenville to Fayetteville.
That's exactly right.
Raleigh to whatever's on the other side. And then
the future looks great.
It does.
It looks great for our community and the possibilities of what can happen in our community.
Yeah, really. You think about it.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, we're talking about I-795 being
exactly
extended.
Right.
We're talking about rail transportation for freight and such, and even for passenger rail.
Right.
So this is an important meeting right here, and I really would like to see that the place full.
Well, and it's sponsored by, of course, Wayne County, the City of Goldsboro, and North Carolina DOT.
DOT.
Department of Transportation.
Oh, yeah, I knew that.
That's right. All right, we also have Business After Hours that is taking place, which, of course, is sponsored through the Wayne County Chamber of Commerce.
DOT.
If you're interested in getting involved in our community, finding out more about other businesses, or becoming a chamber member, you should go and network at this Business After Hours. It's once a month. This one is Thursday, February the 21st. It's always from 5:30 to 7.
That's right.
Let's see, where is this one going to be? It says, come celebrate and make new business contacts. RE/MAX, that's where it's going to be. Brought to you by RE/MAX.
And Jeffries, and this is going to be at the RE/MAX office on Cashwell Drive.
There you go.
2711.
Kim can't see the numbers. 2711
well,
Cashwell Drive.
Well, it's not written in English, no.
Is that what it is?
That's
Spanish?
Probably. That's, well,
and
no,
I
it's
Spanish?
Not. I don't know what it is.
Well, business anyway. After hours. We want to see you there.
That's right. That's
right. Opportunity to make all kinds of business contacts.
We need to blow this up. That's what we need to
we
do to kind of help you out there.
Yes, we do.
Okay.
He's telling my secrets. that I need glasses.
Oh, boy. If you got a check in the mail
from
the IRS
uh-oh.
For $4 million.
Ooh, what would you do with it?
What would you do with it?
That would take a little bit of thought.
All right, now think about this now. You all right, now this is not just any kind of a check. This is a tax refund.
A tax refund.
For an individual.
Mm-hmm.
Now, you might think, wow, what's that all about? Because I was only supposed to get back like $4 or $10, you know.
Uh-oh.
Yeah. If you got a check back for $4 million, what would you do? Well, most people would call the IRS or go to the nearest office and say, you know, I think this is maybe a mistake. But not this genius.
Uh-oh.
Not only was he not the only genius in the house, but there was a guy at the bank that wasn't real bright either. Seems that a $4 million tax return was just too good to be true, because it just wasn't true at all. A fellow by the name of Francis E. Chandler III has pleaded guilty to charges related to cashing an IRS check for nearly $4 million.
Wow.
The Honolulu Star Advertiser reports Chandler faces a maximum 5-year prison term plus a fine. He's also agreed to repay the government about $3 million after about $900,000 was recovered. Now, see, here's the whole thing. Here's why, and that's not in the story. What I question is, it seems that he actually cashed the check. It doesn't say that, but it says he's charged and has
to repay.
Cashing a check,
yeah.
He has to repay. Who cashed his check? And what planet are they from?
Mm-mm-mm.
Okay. Anyway, that's a legitimate story out of Honolulu. Yes.
Dear gracious.
And fellas, if you're... I've got a story for you.
All right, be careful.
This is for guys, okay? You know what a guppy is. A guppy's a little fish.
Yes.
All right. Guppies, researchers say male guppies love to hang on to their ugly guppy buddies when they're looking for a mate. If you're a good-looking guppy, you want to hang around with ugly guppies. And there's a reason for it, it seems.
Well, please do tell.
The study found that the drab-colored guppies make their finned friends really look good. Hmm. As one of the researchers puts it, hey, if you're surrounded by ugly friends, you look better. The study on the guppy dating game is published by Britain's Royal Society, one of the world's oldest science organizations. So the whole thing is, if you're looking for love, hang around with your ugly pals.
I cannot believe we just said that.
I can't either.
Yeah, I can't believe they spent money on a guppy study.
They spent money on a guppy study.
And who does that?
The British Royal Society, one of the world's oldest science organizations.
Of course it is. There you go.
I can't believe I just read that story either.
Me either, but let's move on.
What's
talking about fish, we're going to talk a little bit about shad, because there's a shad tournament that is going to be taking place right here in our community. Saturday, March the, is that 16th?
Yes, it is. Where are your glasses?
I don't know. March the 16th at 7 a.m., Goldsboro Parks and Recreation is going to be partnering with Easy Bait and Tackle. Let's see. Oh, yeah, it's a $10 entry fee per angler. If you have questions or would like to talk to someone more about the Shad Festival, you just caught that, right? You can call Goldsboro Parks and Recreation, and they can give you details on this festival. But it will be taking place March 18th.
16th.
I can't see it, so there you go. That is so funny to you that I can't see.
It kind of sort of is there, you know. It is, yeah. Okay. Ugly guppies and shad. And
yes.
Chad. Oh, yes. The answer to our trivia question for today. Do we have we haven't had one yet, have we?
I don't think so.
We have a trivia question here. Here's a trivia question for today.
All right. Tell us the question.
What planet are we on? Duh. Okay. Here's a trivia question for today.
Yes.
No. Here's a trivia answer for today. The question was, in what year of this century did Sir Isaac Newton predict the apocalypse would happen? He predicted the apocalypse would happen in the year 2060.
Okay.
And this is 13. That means we only have, 47 years?
Yeah, you got 47 years.
That's based on the prophecy on the book of Daniel in the Bible. According to Isaac Newton, who read the Bible quite a bit, as a matter of fact, he predicted 2060 would be the year of apocalypse.
How many predictions have we heard through the years?
Quite a few. And in fact, there was one here recently in the last year or so, and some people actually took that seriously.
I know.
But let me tell you something. You just don't know.
You don't.
Nobody knows.
You don't.
All right, what else do we have here?
Well, we've got a long list of activities. If you're interested in doing something, you can call Goldsboro Parks and Recreation or go to their Facebook page or go to their website, because they have everything from a fitness room that you can go and use for $20 a year. $20
a year. That's less than $2 a month.
I mean to tell you. They've got cheerleading. They've got self-defense classes, bingo, boxing, Zumba, Family Feud. The list goes on and on. If you're interested in doing things right here locally and at a very inexpensive price, many of them for free, check it out, Goldsboro Parks and Recreation.
And this, how do you get this information?
Well, you can go to their website.
Okay.
Well, you can always go to goldsboronc.gov and click on departments. It'll take you straight to Goldsboro Parks and Recreation. Or if you've got Facebook, just type in Goldsboro Parks and Rec. It'll take you right there.
Wow. Okay. Outstanding. All right. Today is Tuesday. Who's on the program tomorrow, Kim?
Tomorrow we have Sherry Archibald will be here with the Paramount Theater talking about all the things that are coming up the rest of February and through the month of March.
Wow.
And let's see, I believe we have Jimmy Edmondson here talking about the Military Affairs Committee.
Military Affairs Committee, yeah.
I think that's it.
That's it. So join us tomorrow at 7 o'clock for those interviews. And, of course, we'll be here as well. That's at 7 o'clock, and then again at noon, then again 5:30, and then again and again and again and
that's
again.
Right. We're here to keep you updated so you'll know and be informed on what's happening right here in your community.
Exactly right. So until 7 o'clock tomorrow morning, I'm Wayne Alley.
And I'm Kim Best. Thank you for being with us.